Apple AirPods are great for what they are, especially if you own an Apple device. But there is one consideration, at least for me and my ears, that Apple didn't take into consideration. That is, when I'm eating, these things fall out, like a lot. So, what's the boy to do? Hey folks, Tony Hannity's here, and just before we get started, I want to say thank you for hanging in there. I know it's been a while since there's been any kind of actual evergreen content on this channel. I've been extremely busy with some of my other projects, including Lazy Music Reacts, especially my Twitch channel, twitch.tv/LazyTechTony. So if you want to keep the conversation going on, that's a great place to do it, as well as my podcast, the Still Recording Podcast with Mr. Quentin McKinnon. Talk about pretty much anything under the sun that has nothing to do with anything. So if you're looking for a podcast about nothing, the George Costanza model, might want to check us out. Back to the subject at hand, I've been looking for some wireless Bluetooth earbuds that would work very well with my iPhone, that wouldn't cause any kind of delay, it wouldn't cause any hindrance for anything such as eating or running around doing things. And so far, these Soundpeats, these are the True Engine 3 SE Soundpeats, have been doing pretty decently well. So let's talk about it. First off, they come in this nice little case. Now, comparatively to the AirPods, this is much bigger, and it's not really perfect or good for someone that has skinny jeans or something like that, because it definitely bulges out. Hence, I never actually take the case with me while walking around. I actually just leave it in my car. So, little minus one point right there. But the charging case is pretty phenomenal. It takes about 2 hours to fully charge it, 30 hours of continuous playtime, and about 150 hours of standby time, according to them. Now, my real world experience is I would use it about every day, give or take 30 to an hour minutes every single day. And I've been using it for the past 3-4 weeks now, and I only had to charge it once within that time frame. So fairly impressive, if I'm being honest right there. Also, of course, it is USB Type-C on the back of this thing, so good on you for doing that. Still, I see a lot of Bluetooth headphones that are still micro USB for some reason. And if you want to check out a mask that has an integrated Bluetooth earbuds into them, you can check out Mask Phone in the top right corner. Wasn't bad. They weren't bad. It's just, you know, when you're trying to do things that don't require the mask, but you still want to listen to your music or be on the phone call, it's a little weird. But going back to this guy, you've got Bluetooth 5.0, audio codecs of SBC and APTX, and the range is your standard Bluetooth range, just about 30 feet, give or take 10 meters, if you will, and a bunch of other technologies, A2DP, AVRCP, all that other stuff. If you know what all that stuff is, it has it. If you don't know what all that stuff is, it just basically, it's good. It's good to have. You can connect this to your computer, you connect to your phone, whatever, you're good. And one of the issues that I had with other Bluetooth headphones is that there was a ginormous latency between what I was watching on screen, especially if it was something on YouTube, to what I was listening, and it was extremely jarring. No issues whatsoever with this. And this is IPX5, so it is waterproof to a degree. You can take it in the rain, or in the snow, or the sleet, or the hail, or shower, or the hot tub, whatever you have in your lifestyle. Arguably, you can take it with you. So all the points are there. This is really, really nice. They're very, very small, but not too small. They fit right into your ears. There's a bunch of tips that you can try out to see which fits best into in your ears. Also, from a design standpoint, it's kind of cool. You can actually see the drivers, the dual drivers that are in each of these earbuds. And I don't know, just from a technological standpoint, it's cool to see how things are working and how they make the sounds from ones and zeros go bo 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 bo. But what are the downsides? Well, I did have some connection issues between the two. So during my test runs of just walking about doing my thing, I would put one earbud in and the other earbud in. The audio would say connected, as she does, and I would wait for another like bloop in the other pair. Or rather, the other brother, we'll call it brother, the other brother to talk to each other. And there was some times when it just wouldn't. Like I would have them in my ears for a good 10, 15 seconds and only the right one would connect. I would put them back in their case and put it back on and it would be fine. So a little bit of issue there. Not the end of the world though, because you know, things like that can happen. The other issue I have is kind of more of an aesthetic feel to it. It has a matte black look and feel, which is nice. I'm a big fan of the matte black look and feel, or matte anything, matte red, matte blue, matte LeBlanc, anything. But the fact of the matter is it's also very fingerprinty. So if you like the clean look, you're gonna see a lot of fingerprints with this matte soft touch. So you might want to, like, you know, use a microfiber cloth to clean it every once in a while. And the last thing I would say that was of considerable annoyance were the gestures or the tap controls to use the functions that are on board the earbuds. Now, I say this with the complete realization there's only so much you can do with just one earbud. But there were definite times where I only had one earbud in because I had to hear something with my other ear, my actual ear. So I took one earbud out, but I was still listening to whatever I was listening to. And I would have to tap this, whichever one was in, and it would do something. Now, the caveat is each earbud does something different. Now, there were some commands where it worked in both. Like if you double tap while listening to a song, it'll pause or play it. Or if you double tap when a phone call comes in, it'll answer or end the call. That's nice because you can have either or in there. No problems there. But the issues begin when you need to increase or lower the volume or skip a track. You have to use both to be able to do that because the right one will increase the volume. The left one will decrease the volume, or the right one will skip forward and the left one will skip back. And again, if you have both in your ears, it is not a big deal at all. And fundamentally, you would have both in your ears about 80% of the time. But the nice thing about the earbuds, whether they're these or the AirPods or whatever else that are out there, Galaxy Buds, is that you have the availability to just take one out and just have one in so you can still be connected with the real world around you. But if you can only be connected half of the way because you only have half of the controls, it's a little bit, I said it before and I'll say it again, it's a little bit annoying. And there's got to be a better word for it. My vocabulary is lacking right now. I'm going to put a word on screen and it's going to be a really good synonym now. Nevertheless, going out and about doing the things that I do on my day job and my family life and whatnot, utilizing this on the bike trails, just walking down the street singing Doo Wah Diddy and all the other good stuff, I had no problems with it whatsoever. But the one test that won me over completely was the eating test. Because I've tried the One Mores, not the One Pluses, but I tried the One Mores, tried the AirPods, I've tried even the AirPod Pros. I've tried some other name brands and off brands like M-Power and whatnot. And they all had one thing in common, and that was when I would chew, just normal chewing, not a cow, I don't do that. Just normal chewing, it was inevitable that one or both of the earbuds would just fall out because of how my jawline connects up to my ear canal or whatever, and it would just jostle it down. These guys, not a problem. And honestly, for me, that was kind of the pièce de résistance. That was like, that's it, I'm happy. I guess I'm skipping over the main thing that you guys would be wanting to listening for. How is the sound quality? It's okay. It's not the greatest. It's not very well balanced. It's very mid-level. I don't hear a lot of bass, and the kind of music that I've been listening to recently has a lot of bass, and I don't really hear it. And I guess for my own eardrums, that's a good thing. But, you know, there are certain activities like working out where you want to have that bass to kind of get your blood pumping and whatnot. And these don't really do that. If you can get past that, or if you're not one to really enjoy too much bass, you might be okay. But these didn't have bass. I don't really believe that there is a companion application to increase that. Maybe in your own app like Spotify or Apple Music, there's an equalizer where you can increase the bass. But honestly, you shouldn't have to do that. It should just kind of be there. And although it does have dual drivers, you do get to hear a lot of the mid and the highs, which is nice. But I need that bass. So that's my take on it. If you have any questions or comments, please leave that in the comment section down below. Links, as always, can be found in the description below, including a link to buy your very own pair. If you use that link, a little bit will go back to me. So I appreciate it. Also, if you like this kind of content, make sure you thumbs up this video, subscribe to the channel, share it with your friends. I do stream on Twitch, twitch.tv/LazyTechTony. Some of the streams are gaming related, obviously. Some of them are with my daughter, and we have our other channel on there too and our other podcasts. Nevertheless, it'd be great to have you guys come along and carry on the conversation. Until then, see you in the next one. Later.